actually tomorrow we have a faculty show. All of our teachers come on and they do an improv show together. If you guys want to check that out, Thursday's a really fun night here at the Westside as well. So, but yeah, all the information you need is on the website or through me. And that's it. So let's get the reason why you guys are all here. You guys, I'm so glad that you guys are here because he's going to South Dakota for a month on Sunday. So we can't see him for 30 plus today plus Sunday. I can't do the math in days, but you understand that we're all very excited to be here for him. Please put your hands together for the very funny Mr. Brian O'Sullivan!
Everybody. All right, cool. These are the people I don't have to remove from friends on Facebook. Appreciate you guys coming. My name is Brian O'Sullivan. I'm a singing comedian. By a round of applause, who has never seen me before? So hard. Here we go. Here's a song that you guys all on the same page about who I am and what I do. I want to introduce myself to everyone. This really shouldn't take too long. Hi, my name is Brian. What's yours?
Brian.
Thanks for ruining this part of my song. Back to me! I'm awesome. I'm from LA, singing jokes, as you will see. What's the 44th president's favorite vegetable? Broccoli. Too soon? My name is Brian O'Sullivan, and I'm a singing comedian. I will stab myself in the face if you ask me, have you heard about Burnham? My name is Brian O'Sullivan, and I'm a singing comedian. I'd like to thank my dad for not pulling out on that night when my life began. It's okay, Spencer, I'm Catholic. When I say B-R-I-A-N, you say O'Sullivan. Better than college audiences. When I say Brian, you say it's hilarious. Brian! Brian! When I say Brian, you say it's my hero. Brian! Brian! When I say Brian, you say it's so hot. Brian!
So hot!
Thank you. Paul? My name is Brian O'Sullivan, and I'm a singing comedian. Now that everybody knows my name, it's time for this song to now in the thank you guys so much. In case you missed it in that last song, my name is Brian O'Sullivan, and I'm a singing comedian. We're on the same page. Okay, great. This is a new song I wrote. You guys heard of Ed Sheeran, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. It's my audience participation for the show. Improv done. And have you guys played the board game Clue?
Yes!
Does anyone know the premise of the board game Clue? Like, who dies at the beginning before the game starts? Mr. Body. Mr. Body. Yeah, Mr. Black in some parts of the world, but Mr. Body. For the purposes of this song, what I wrote, it's Mr. Body in America, the only country in the world. And that only matters because that's the whole reason I wrote this parody, is because of the name of the person that is killed at the beginning of the game, so it's important to that part. Let's skip this song. Here we go, here we go. Love any chance I get to commit murder. Are you game enough, full Hasbro? Me and some friends all named after different colors after two dimensions we roll. Make my way to the ballroom conservatory of study. This must be a secret passage now. Once I'm inside the room, this could be all over soon. I'll pull my platypicular guess who, saying something like, girl, I think Professor Plum with the candlestick while in the library. Come on, disprove my theory. If you've got the card, then show me, say, boy, you are really dumb. Hand me a card, the library, it reads. Got it now, mark my sheet. Gosh darn it, there goes my lead. I'm in love with the board game Clue, but the British version Cluedo too. Thinking no risk, it accused, but if you're wrong, you'll be sorry. Now I'm in the dining room. I'll bring you in cause I think it's you. Every turn discovering something brand new. To find who killed Mr. Body. I think I know. Know who killed Mr. Body. I think I know. Just who killed Mr. Body. I think I know. Did you kill Mr. Body? Don't give me D&D battleship or taboo. I'm in love with the board game. Miss Scarlet, dining room, lead pipe. Cellar, candlestick, Mrs. White. Biller, broom, the ranch, Mr. Green. Colonel Mustard, dagger, study. Mrs. Peacock, rope, library. Revolver, conservatory. Professor, from hall, candlestick. The lounge, the ballroom, or kitchen. I'm in love with the board game clue. First thing get through, your cranium will tell you. A mastermind won't be sorry. Like in an operation room, it's anything but a trivial pursuit. Feel the magic floating upwards until you find out who killed Mr. Body. Miss Scarlet, dining room, lead pipe. Cellar, candlestick, Mrs. White. Biller, broom, the ranch, Mr. Green. Colonel Mustard, dagger, study. Mrs. Peacock, road, library. Revolver, conservatory. With 324 ways to conclude, I'm in love with the board game clue. That's fast. Let's slow things down for a minute. Do you guys want to hear a love song?
Yeah.
Great, that's what we're doing. Here we go. It's a love song I wrote for a Cyclops. I need more friends. Right, everybody in the front row? Love song for a Cyclops. Pick up girls using stupid pickup lines. Yeah, that's what you were thinking, right, Ryan? Yeah. And if you think that, you're wrong, because I'm terrified of talking to girls in real life. But I do spend a lot of time alone in my room thinking about what I would say to a girl if I had the courage to talk to her. So do you guys know what metaphors and similes are? Yes, you laugh, but when I ask college kids that, for those of you that don't know, similes are like metaphors. So I wrote a bunch of metaphors, similes, and puns, and I put them in this to this bit. This song's called Hey Girl. Hello, nurse. I see you on my bed rocker. These jokes are gonna come real fast in this song. Cyclops love song, easy one to follow. This one a little faster. You guys are gonna love this one. We can use the jokes on each other. That first line was, hello nurse, I see you. Still just as funny, huh? You guys are kind of my next show too. It's the exact same set. Like intensive care unit, also there you are. Never mind, this is gonna be a long song for some people. We're doing it anyway, here we go. Hello nurse, I see you. I'll make your bed rock out. Nope, nice shoes. Do you come here a lot? If you did, I would. Cause you're so cute and Campbell's good. I wanna be your sweet honey. Like a rhino playing trumpet, I'm so horny. Do you wanna make up? Here's a kiss from France. Put your jeans above your head, I can see your underpants. Girl, would you sign me? Don't say stop. Like a can of Pringles, I'm about to pop. Blow me like the big bad wolf did. I'll be praying like a menace that you eat my kids. Hey ho, hey ho. Hey girl. Bill Hartman's wife. I shoot for the stars. Don't do that. Tool for your box, get nailed, let's screw. You're the shit, I'm number two. I'm deep and I'm gonna be inside your mouth. You're Randy Johnson, I'm striking out. Tell me that you're Jane Grey. Where's my head at? Would you shave downstairs? I'm allergic to cats. Hey, my mom is so proud of me. I said, ride me like a convertible in May. You could take my top off every day. Oh, hey, oh. Me say day, oh. Come, Mr. Tallyman, I'm telling you when I'm done. Hey, oh, hey, oh. I mean, hey, oh. Hey, Miss New York, I'm glad we met. You're an old man's boner, you're hard to get. But like Monopoly, I can play that game. Ugly things on your tears, you'll be glad you came. I brought my golf this shaft, I'll drive, call me JCPenney. I'll be all inside, I'm gonna fill you up. I'm a tank of gas, there's a dunk in your pants, let me see that ass. My balls are the Smurfs, cause they're turning blue. I'll make a moan in the shower like I'm selling shampoo. Since they healed, do you want a bone? Like my Kelly Colkin, I go home alone. Suck Brian, now I don't even care. Cause I used to be so good at quips, but now everything I know, it must be wrong. Cause I like Justin Bieber songs, and now my life feels like it's all backwards. So JB, you should go and fuck yourself. And if you think that I'm being immature, well fucking fuck, go fucking fuck yourself. Da 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 but you've made me believe. I'm such a fan, now will you please spit on me? Do you still love Selena? Sorry, what do you mean? Never say never, where are you now, baby? Because I think that I've gone gay for you. And JB, you should go and fuck yourself. And do you think that I can watch while you do? Or just let me watch you fuck yourself. Cause if this song was me and I was you, then I would definitely fuck myself. Because I used to hate everything you do. Now I hate that I love yourself. You guys hear some jokes? The fuck do you think I've been doing? Jeez, judgmental much. All right, fine, we'll do some jokes. These are all jokes I wrote and I put them up on Facebook. And if they got 10 likes or more, I put them in this bin. Hey, I felt very validated those few days. When I see a business sign that says everything must go, I take the sign. Anytime I meet a girl named Destiny, I realized there was no way to avoid that. The price of blow-up dolls has increased. I think this is due to inflation. I love the Olive Garden. But I would never take a date there. Because when you're there, you're family, and that's gross. I found out a couple months ago, that joke does not work in Arkansas. No idea why. I recently got in a race with one of my friends to see who could put something around their neck faster. It was a tie. The greatest one-hit wonder of all time is the Titanic. Too soon? Too soon? You get like a 100-year grace period, and it's fair game. Which one too soon rules? Yeah. All down comforters are extremely comfortable. That's a blanket statement. And a joke for nerds. I couldn't find my shake weight this morning.
Shake weight.
Well, I'm not gonna top that, so sweet. That's how that joke ends tonight. That was better that way. One of my ex-girlfriends recently texted me, trying to remember the name of the game, Mortal Kombat. But what she texted me was, hey Brian, what's the name of that fighting game that I love? So I replied, it's called a relationship. She's terrible at that game. Always using the cheat code. By which I mean she cheated on me. Hilarious. After that, I found out there's actually a dating website called glutenfreesingles.com. I feel like everybody on that site is actually inbred. That joke also does not work in Arkansas. My roommate recently made fun of me for locking the bathroom door when I shower. The fact that my roommate knows I lock the bathroom door when I shower is exactly why I lock the bathroom door when I shower. That creep. Listen, Joe. close to that. I was gonna try a different song right here, but I'm not ready to perform it, so let's see. Do you guys know what idioms are?
No.
Idioms.
No.
This, shout out an example of an idiom if you know what one is.
No.
Ah, gotcha. Yeah, I was gonna need a quiz. We're just trying to further the show, Brian. No one has any? All right, so idioms are like phrases that shortcut a meaning in one language but don't directly translate in another language correctly. So like, to beat around the bush, means, you know, not just tell me the answer. But if you translate that like in Spanish, they'd be like, why are you talking about hitting bushes? Or like, you know, one in the hands were two in the bush. Or other ones that don't have to do with bush. Well, for some reason, that's all my mind for that. It's the Justin Bieber's. So I wrote this song for people that don't know what idioms are, so we'll see how this one goes. Everybody, it seems like. Yeah, this is a song for this part of the room. Pay attention, guys. There's a lot of idioms in this song. I threw my cap on the ground at the drop of a hat. Now that's the third time I've done a hat trick like that. What's up fraternity for? It's all Greek to me. I work the graveyard shift at the cemetery. Lil Jon runs the show, cause he calls the shots. You can't outmarry a fisherman, they're the best of time or not. Are you bad at math? Give 110%. Please pardon my French, for the soup du jour tastes like shit. That mind just yelled action, speak louder than words. To turn that frown upside down, you need to bend over backwards. The MSG in my Chinese food gave me brain fog. And if you are what you eat, I'm gonna be sick as a dog. What's an idiom, you idiot? If you don't know what an idiom is, you must be illiterate, you idiot. The lights are on, but no one is home. That's an idiom for idiot. Do you get it? Sorry, I don't mean to be inconsiderate. Do you need a hint? Here, let me throw you a bone. When my husky dreams, he sets the truth aside. I always find it's best to let sleeping dogs lie. I look buff in clothes, I rarely drink Blue Moon. Dumbo, let's talk about the elephant in the room. I'm gonna go out on a limb and guess you hate climbing trees. I didn't like my beard at first, but now it's growing on me. If God gives you lemons, don't buy cars from God. Peeping Toms go to jail, but they always get off. What's an idiom, you idiot? If you still don't know what an idiom is, I'll repeat, you're an idiot. You're not the brightest crayon in the box. That's an idiom for idiot. Do you get it? Are you dumber than a box of rocks? You can't eat your words if you bite your tongue. If Smith and Wesson had a boy, he'd be a son of a gun. I'm still on the fence about what makes a good neighbor. Hard candy for a diabetic could be a lifesaver. I wonder what happened. I kept the cat in the bag. Well, he suffocated. My curiosity killed the cat. When it rains, it pours, and when it pours, it's fall. Hookers think with their head when they're on the ball. Viagra Town to your left, on your right, Dwayne Johnson's face. Now you're stuck between a rock and a hard place. Like taking candy from a baby boy, that kid's a sucker. Last but not least, keep an eye out for skull fuckers. You're gonna wanna keep an eye out, cause you see one. What's an idiom, you idiot? If you still don't know what an idiom is, just forget it, you're an idiot. You're as useful as tits on a floor. That's an idiom for idiot, cause tits on a floor are useless as shit, cause that's a male pig, you idiot. The elevator doesn't go to the top floor. Thanks for letting me play that one, guys. The colleges don't let me play that one. It's too dirty for me, guys. The kids are getting smarter today, guys. We have nothing to worry about. I have a new girlfriend. Thank you, four people. I wrote her a song. So if you guys just indulge me for a second, I'm gonna play the song for my new girlfriend. I worked hard to make sure I kept you in every moment with you. great. Couldn't wait to see you. I loved being with you, but now that love's fading towards hate. Wish I never would have sex with you. 'Cause ever since then, there's so much shit I'm required to do. I have to hold your doors and share my showers. Checking via text every couple of hours. Walk with you through Forever 21 and read more books because you tell me it's fun. I have to buy you shit and say I miss you. Hold your hand in public and constantly kiss you. Put up with your baby voice and say I want kids. There's no I in relationship. Wait. Yes, there is. I knew I wanted all of you forever. Ooh, baby, it's true. But I didn't realize what forever really felt like until I started hanging out with you. I remember how great it felt when I said I love you. I didn't feel trapped at all until you said, I love you too. 'Cause now when I say I, what I mean is we. And I have to watch The Bachelor every fucking week. I go to brunch with your friends who won't leave me alone. And you make me share the password on my phone. My arm falls asleep 'cause we spoon each night. And I'm learning really quickly that I'll never be right. Don't get to think for myself, we do what you wanna do. There's an I in relationship. There's no you. Hey, now I shave my pubic hair because you say you like it bare. And if I don't, you tell me you won't ever go down there. You sip on all of my drinks whenever we go out. And you always want to know, what are you thinking about? I don't know! Fucking nothing! Stop asking me! I'm so sorry, baby. I didn't mean that. Can you just close the bathroom door? I promise we can talk about whatever you want to when I'm finished in here. The day you left me was the day my heart began to bleed. I truly thought you would be my wife. But I was so wrong. Know how my life will go on. Being with you was the best week of my life. So I'm single again. I'm kind of a very fun, special part of the show. The reason why at least three of you are here. I'm going to go ahead and introduce one of my very good friends. Everyone, give it up for Jamie Pierce.
Thank you for having me, Brian.
Thanks for coming.
I have to apologize. I promised the fans that tonight I would be wearing a romp him. But I went to buy one and they were all sold out. Brian bought them all. He cleared them out.
I didn't want you to wear it.
It's good to show off my shapely calves and my
decolletage. Less is more.
Less is more. Yeah.
Good tip.
Alright, so here's a song we're gonna duet here.
I have to complete my Stevie Nicks fantasy.
I thought we were going to use a tambourine.
No, it's important.
What?
It's essential.
Yeah, it's going to mess up my timing. It's so perfect.
What timing would that be?
Shut up. So I wrote this song 4 days after the election of last year. I don't know if you guys remember that. And I normally stay away from political humor much at all. That was before. Now you can't really get away from it at all. But this is a song I've never played before.
World premiere. World exclusive.
Yeah. only reason I wrote it is because the rhymes. There's some rhymes in here that go along with the original song. So the week after the election, the song Closer was the number one song in the country.
The Chainsmokers.
Those beautiful
Smoking
singing
kills.
DJs. So I wrote a parody of that song Closer, and Jamie's gonna help me with this parody right here for the maybe the one and only performance of it ever.
Mm-hmm. We had our finger on the pulse.
We did.
Current political.
Here we go. Just like this. Hey, I'm going to paint in a burnt out orange tank, looking like a suit in a large garbage can buffet. USA, where it's hard to be a rich white man, but you'll make America great again. My friends say I'm smart, trust me, I have the smartest friends in. We're gonna build that wall, but first I got a Twitter war with Alec Baldwin, and I can't be stopped. And I find my daughter so hot. Technically the nation chose her, cause the fact is that more voters voted that they don't support that white fascist pussy Grover. But those females we must scold her, must she also kill four soldiers? Global warming must be over, feel our nation getting colder.
Wait, that's too soon. Wall Street. Okay. Every time I turn the news on, I can see lies by the clues on your face. I'd wait my turn to be president is all I wanted. I didn't feel the burn. You forgot to say tree when you called me country. I can't be stopped. Think about that one. My numbers drop. It couldn't have been closer. Bash my head in with a boulder. This election was depressing. Took forever to be over. Now the streets on every corner have protesters who don't know. Could it be that PC culture, hypocrisy's the composer? Marco Rubio was pretty.
Ted Cruz was just plain scary.
But he outlasted Rick Perry.
The EC seems like a tech school run by Trump University. The DNC picked Hillary, but her fans just wanted Bernie.
And her fans just wanted Bernie.
And her fans just wanted Bernie.
All her fans just wanted Bernie.
All her fans just wanted Bernie.
Yeah, her fans just wanted Bernie.
All her
ideas are cool, but like when you give me like actual songs, it's like I write all my material, so it's I don't know why I'm telling you this, but here's another song I wrote.
Don't introduce songs. I'm just a 65-year-old woman. The person singing the song doesn't look 65. Then he stole the song. Then it was that stupid singing comedian, Brian O'Sullivan. He's always just hanging around my house and stealing my songs. I guarantee that he doesn't pay attention to the words I wrote. Probably just memorized the song, not really reading a thing. I guarantee that he's using that stupid John Mayer voice. He thinks it sounds good. Brian's not sensitive, he's an idiot. Plus Brian has herpes, the genital kind, which is surprising considering he's only had sex one time and that girl killed herself. Brian's penis is exactly the same size now as it was the day he was born, and in his free time he watches child porn. Audience gets the joke of the song. Brian probably doesn't do it, so I'll go on and on and on and on. The worst thing a comic can do is have an unfunny bit that goes on for way too long. But that's typical for one of Brian's songs. Has Brian fake laughed yet? He'll do it when he's nervous. Stop this song and apologize. Sorry. Oh. Then he'll probably pretend that he forgot the words. Oh, what a bacon nerd. Brian is a one-trick, not funny pony. He's so phony. Brian is dumb. He'll never be a star. A real comedian doesn't need a guitar. My name's Brian and I didn't write this song. My name's Brian and I didn't write this song. If the song is going poorly, Brian just asks everyone to sing along. Everybody sing! My name's Brian and I didn't write this song. Guys, I only have one song left tonight for you. That's so sweet of you. Come to my next show. It'll be sometime in 2018.
Or come to South Dakota.
So you guys have fun tonight? Give yourselves a round of applause. You guys have something to come on. Thank you all sincerely for being here tonight. You made it worth my while. So for the last song, if you guys do want to follow me online or stuff, you're welcome to. You can find all my information at bocomedy.com because my initials stink. Dad jokes. I have one album on iTunes. I have another album that's supposed to be coming out last July. Probably coming out this July. I'm working on mastering the tracks right now. So that should be on iTunes and Spotify and all that stuff soon enough. But BO Comedy has all that information. This last song for you guys I'm going to do. Fun fact we figured out, like, Brian likes puns, he likes stupid pickup lines, and he likes board games. If we learned nothing else tonight, let it be that. So for this this song, I own 42 versions of Monopoly. I know. And what I did... As I opened up one of the games of Monopoly, you guys are here just for the good stuff. That's right at time. We waited for you. I'm like, you know what? We're going to do a solid 50 minutes first, and then they'll come in and we'll do the best song just for them. So, Monopoly, this is the best song, by the way. They don't know it yet. It's going to be the best song for you guys, I promise. Of all of my songs you've heard. So I open up the board game Monopoly, and I try to see how many puns I could pull from Monopoly and turn them into pickup lines. Yeah, you guys are super excited to hear where this is going, huh? Oh, cool. This is your closer, Brian? All right, so I got my DJ up in the booth there. It'll be the Monopoly song. This song's called Monopoly Pickup Lines, and all you need to know is that every single line in this song has at least one pun from Monopoly in it. Here we go.